So we will look to this table, and based on this table we will draw on this whiteboard the network. How to construct the network from this one. So we have to start from A. As we make the rules in the previous slide, we have to make an activity. This is number one, this is number two. This one is A, and the load how much it? 3. It will take 3 weeks, for example.
Okay.
And A, nothing is there before. This is the starting point. Come back to B. Hire personnel, it takes 4, and previous one is
A.
A. So from A, we have to go to B, which is
4.
4. The weight is 4.
Okay.
C, D, and E. C, B, and D, and E. They are
all from A.
Yeah, they are all from A. Like this, from A, so we have to put this one, to put this one. So let's assume this one B, or this one B, and this one D, and this one E.
No, C, E.
No, C. C is previous, huh? Okay. C and, okay. So this is B and this one C. And this is E. Yes or no?
Yes.
So,
The weight of 4.
Weight?
4.
4 B is 4.
Also C.
4 C is?
4.
4?
4 E is 4.
4 E is 4. Mm-hmm. All are same. But they are parallel activities. And now back to D. D is after?
From C.
After C. Yes or no?
Yes.
So how to put it? We can make it from here, yes?
Yes.
But is it to here or to here? We have to go see if there is a D is written here. Yes, it is written with B. There is one activity, it will be between them. So this one it will be D.
Yes.
And these two. Direction it will be this. It should be like this.
Okay.
Otherwise, okay. So now F. F is
from C.
From C. So we can do it like this. This is F, and weight is
6.
6. Okay.
G from D and B.
And G from D and B. J,
yeah.
This is D and B, they are, so we have to come from this. This is J, and the load is 3. And H is before E.
Yes, from E.
So how to do? H.
E and J and there are H. We didn't try them.
No, no, but see, H
from E.
It should be before E, yes? But now come to I.
G.
Before F and G. F and G is that what? I. So,
from F.
Wait. Before, I is coming before F and G. So, this one should be like this. And this is called what? I. This is F. This is F. And what is the weight of F? 6.
Yes.
Yes or no? Now when we want to draw I, it comes before G and F. That is right.
Yes.
And here now we want to put here, I think we're learning one like this, one like this. This is H, which is one, and this activity,
I.
I, which is carried 12.
From
and after that, J is the last one.
From I and H.
It is like this. Now, because before J, there is I and H.
Yes.
So now the project are finished. And in this way, this two. After that, we have to look for the what is critical path for this. This is once you draw it like this, now you cut long stem for selection. Now we know how the parallel is come, how each activity is working before each one. It's like this, and we have to stop at J and start at A. That is one solution. How to calculate the critical path and slacks? We will go to the next slides one by one and definitions, and until we come, then we can, in this blackboard, we will solve. So let's back to the slides. Let's back to our slides. Step 5, event analysis. Event-oriented analysis is used primarily in PERT because it is especially convenient for risk analysis involving group probabilities of combination. The following procedure is used in event analysis. Inter-time estimates on the network. It is estimates. This is PERT. Compute the earliest and latest date for all events. Find the slack on the events and identify critical events. Find the slack on the activities and identify critical activities. Find the critical. All this one you can take from this table, from this network. Step by step, how to get this one. But he is telling here how computer can do it. There is some algorithm. Step A, conduct a forward pass. That was find ET, that's earlier time. Early time for each activity and late time for each activity. We have to do like this one, that's in the next step, we'll do it in black. In order to compute early time for an event, the duration of each path leading to the event is computed. If several paths lead to an event, then the path with the largest elapsed time is selected. Largest. So we have to come from this. Left to right, take the largest path until you get here. That is the largest. And when you come back to take to calculate the slack, back to calculate the smallest one. So we will solve this example and solve another example and it will be. Note that for computation of each early time it is not necessary to return to the beginning of the network. Because you calculate from this one, you this one to calculate and again like this. Length of a path, duration of last activity on path, plus early time of the preceding credits. We want to calculate for this, for example, it is the duration of the last one plus this one. This is one example, this is our network. Is it same or? Yeah, same. Same, there is just changing names. Otherwise, it's the same. I, A. Yeah. We are doing BG here, he is doing it, that's this side. And he is taking this and that side. Otherwise, everything is. He is taking C above. This side. This is the network, how to make it for most lake projects. It is one example. Step B, conduct backward pass. Then every time we have to go from this side to this side. Backward pass, we have to go back to calculate later. As I thought, we will solve two examples and we will calculate this. To compute the time of each event, start from the last event, number 8. And forward, backward, all the way to event 1. One by one until it becomes 9. number one. Using the largest elapsed time in the same manner as step A. Assume that the compilation time is set equal to the computed earliest compilation time of the project. Found in step A is equal to this. If you start from here, this is T4, the critical path will come here. 27 lag. This, because there are, in series there is in parallel, but we have to take when we come, what is the total time for the project? So we have to take the largest for each. For example, here this one is take 4 and 1. But you cannot start, this one with this one after combination this one. We have to wait for these things. As you are doing, for example, project in your house. Yes, you start make block and after that marbles, after that one by one. You cannot do marbles before do this one, cement and something. So in project there is some activities cannot be received before others. We have to wait until they finish. Start the next step. Even if we are free, if there is some parallel work is free, they have to wait. That time they are with, that is called slack time. How to calculate and solve, we will do it. Find the slack of the events and identify critical time. The difference between late time and early time for each event is identified as the slack of that event. Slack tells us how long the event can be linger without delaying the entire project. Any delay in a critical event will cause a delay in the entire project. If we are in critical path, if we have any delay in that critical path, any week or any points of time, it will change the total time of the project. That's what we have to do. Slack equal late time minus early time. There are two cases considered in the computation of the slack. When late time equal early time for the last event. Sometimes in the critical path, we have to put here, for each activity we have to put 2 squares. Here, when we start from this side, we have to fill this down. When we come back, we have to fill this. But when we go to the end, the critical path, all critical path, this one should be equal to this one. There is no difference. Easily that, in the previous slide, always, this is late time, this is early time. Always they are different. But in critical path, they are equal to 0. How to calculate? 2 cases in the computation of the slack. When late time equal to 8 time. For the last event, end of project. In this case, slacks in the network can either be 0, where 1, because it is critical. These events are called critical events. Okay, once this, on this one, later, early are equal, so either they are 0 or larger than 0, whereupon these events are said to have a positive slack. When the time not equal early time for the last event, in this case the critical events are defined as those events with the minimum slack, which can be negative when late time is done or early time. All this also can be clearly after examples. Find the slack also. Similar to a slack on events, there are also slack on activities. This slack can tell us how long the activity can linger without, can delay, can stop until the other parallel activities finish. How we can calculate there without proceeding? For example, here, how long we have to wait here? Because we start 3-4 on here, but we would come here at 23, for example, after 23 weeks. Here is 7 weeks old. And this one can be done in the 1 week. So we can either finish in 8 weeks and stop here for 2 months until we follow, until that parallel project finish. Or in this activity can we have three time. We can start in the 7th week, in the 8th, in the 9th, in the 11th, in the 12th, whatever. So these activities, we have the 3 times to do it in long time. This difference in time between the critical path and this one is called the slack. That's the time should be in work for this parallel form. Now it is understood. The slack is also called the total float. In some book it's called float. But because we are in series from the first chapter, we are stealing as slack, we will continue as slack. Some idle time. Critical bar. The critical bar is the bar in the, or bars in the network leading from the beginning to the project, to the end of the project at its end. All of whose activities and events are critical. If we add one number of the units, then the whole project has to be stopped. However, the non-critical parts, sometimes, if you delay it, it will not affect the critical part or the total time of our project. Otherwise, the critical part is that part with the minimum slack on it. It should be no slack. But if there is some delay, it will be minimum slack. Note that there can be more than one critical path in the network. For built networks and projects, there may be. And that the critical path is the longest time-wise path in the network. In our example, 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 8, and also A, C, F, I, G. A to C to F to I to G. This is the critical part. How we calculate that one? That we'll see in the example. It is the longest, yeah. When we, as I told you, we have to put for each one is 2 squared. One for every time, the other for critical time. Let's do that one. This pen. For this one, we start at
0, 0.
Zero, every time. Forget about when we finish, but we have to go step by step. This one, it will be after 3. Yes. If we go this one, 3 plus 4?
7.
7. If we add 8?
7.
3 plus 2, 3 plus 4? 7, here?
Even 7 or?
No, 7 plus 2? 9.
9.
Yes, 7.
3 plus 4?
7.
7. What we have to put?
7 or 9, we choose the
largest one.
The largest.
Largest, we have to put?
Largest.
9. Then, if we go to this one and go to this one, then this has to wait for 2 weeks until this one is finished. Then the total 2, they should. Here it is 7, if we add 6 it will be 13. But we should not put 13, we have to test and solve the remaining. This is 9 plus 3?
12.
12, but this is 13, 12, so 13. We have to put?
Longest.
30. Again here?
25.
It is 7 plus 1? 8.
8 or 25, we choose 25.
We should use 25 and here is 27. This is every time. This is the total time of the project. So, if we want to take less time, we have to start from here back. And we will select the small one. Here. So we start 27, 27. Here 27 minus 2, 25. We have no other option. So 25 minus 1?
24.
24, there is no other connection. So it will be?
24.
Divide.
Here 24 minus 7?